Today, we're using this liquid yeast for sake and spirits to make a mead. Let's try it. So in today's episode, we are going to use this sake and spirits yeast from Yeast and attempt to make a mead with it. Now I've had to do a little research to figure out what yeast nutrient is best and you know, how much sugar to use, all of those things. Essentially, this is for distilling and for sake. Now we want to push this thing at least to 15% because spirits are generally higher ABV and this yeast is graded to do that. It's like a distilling yeast in its own right. Now it has the sake side, which I looked into that, and the sake side gets a little crazy as well. You can only ferment certain ways and it gets crazy. This is a big test. We're gonna see if it works. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna make basically a sugar wash, which is just, I would call it like dissolved sugar. So from what my research, I found that 1 pound of sugar, granulated sugar, equals about 46 points of gravity. Don't know if that's true or not. This is 4 pounds. I am gonna test that theory. I am going to put 1 pound of sugar in here, fill partially up with water, and then come back. We're gonna see how many gravity points that is. And we are gonna use honey, because this is gonna be a mead. So I plan on using roughly, probably around 2 to 2.5 pounds of honey. The first thing we need to do is activate our yeast. This is a smack pack, which means you find the little nutrient pack in there, and then you give it a good old smack. So this thing should start ballooning up and start waking up. I will not put this into the mead until probably 3 hours from now. So let's go ahead and make our sugar wash. All right, so the sugar wash itself gave us about 1.038 points of gravity to start. We just added 3.5 pounds of avocado blossom honey. We are now at 1.120, which is roughly in the realm of 15.8-ish%, I think. And I'll put the correct answer here. That's perfect. That's exactly where we want to be. And again, this distiller's yeast is intended for high gravity brewing. And now we want to, we're gonna let the yeast continue to wake up, but we're gonna add some diammonium phosphate because this needs lots of nitrogen to properly ferment. So let's add some DAP. All right, we're gonna add a whole teaspoon of DAP. Okay, I'll throw a recipe card up here to show you the updated one. We gotta wait for this yeast to really wake up, and like I said, it'll take a little bit. So I'll come back and do another gravity reading in a couple hours when this, before I pitch this, just to make sure my gravity reading is accurate. But now let's wait and then we'll pitch our yeast. All right, we're a month into this test. Now I'll tell you this, it is not dry. It's been kind of chilling at about 1.010. We started at 1.120, so it's chewed through 110 points of gravity, which puts us roughly in the realm of a 14.5%-ish mead. I don't believe it's gonna ferment anymore. I don't see any more activity. So that's interesting. I thought the yeast would chew through everything, but it hasn't. So let's taste test it. Ooh, that's so, that is vastly different, obviously, than wine yeast. It's, the body of this is different for one. It could partially be because of the sweetness, that there's a difference there, but there is this, whoa, there's just like smoothness to it, like early smoothness. You don't get a lot of booziness on it. For it being, you know, 14.5% mead, you'd expect it at a month old to be just like boozy in your face and super yeasty. I'm not really catching that, honestly. I'm getting like this, a really nice palatable smoothness. I really like that. It's definitely got a little bite. It's not perfect, but it has less of a bite than most normal meads at this point. So interesting. Okay, well, I'm not done with this yet. I'm gonna go and move it out of this bucket and into this carboy. We're gonna let it sit for a while longer and see how it changes maybe over the next month, and then we'll come back and do another taste test. Okay, we're back. It's been a month since I did anything with this last little clip. This has been sitting, and I got myself a good friend here, BC, to help me taste test this, and I didn't want to be the one to tell everybody that sake yeast are the new thing.
Yeah, and it's next big thing. That's what I'm hearing.
So I brought BC in to help me give me a thumbs up or thumbs sideways or down. We'll find out.
So tell me about sake yeast real quick. What is this, a Saccharomyces? Is this just like a white wine yeast?
What number is it?
Low ester and volatile. Okay, so it seems like the goal of this yeast is to not cloud up the flavor profile at all and let the flavor of whatever you're fermenting shine through.
Yeah.
Which makes sense for sake, since you're converting starch to sugars and sugars to alcohol.
Correct.
Okay.
And I have tasted this, so I am more familiar with this one than a previous test.
Okay.
So I will tell you that it used 3.5 pounds of avocado blossom
in a 1 gallon
and 1 pound of granulated sugar as a sugar wash. Then I did the honey on top of that.
Okay, so you started it as a sugar wash,
yeah,
and then pitched your honey on top of that.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's weird and fun. Okay.
Yeah. Well, that's what it said. It said to start with the sugar wash, and I was like, I'll just play along. So it was 11:20.
I'm a big fan of, jeez. Okay.
And it firms it out. No, it didn't. Just kidding. 10:10. So
right,
it stopped short of the 21. Come on, why yeast?
Heavy pour for something that stout. Okay. So the nose on this is very floral and like flowery.
Yep.
But it does have like a little bit of like a... Looking forward to that. It does have a little bit of like a honey bear honey scent. Like,
yeah,
you can tell this is made with honey just because of what you pick up in the nose.
Right.
Which I like. Like, I want, particularly for a traditional mead, you want to know that there's honey in there. Otherwise, why'd you make it a mead?
I've already tasted it. I do get a little bit of the granulated sugar taste that comes associated. You don't get it on the nose.
Have heat.
It does have heat. It definitely has some heat.
Like, I'm getting a little bit of buzz just by bringing 14. This into
this
the lungs.
This is 14 and a half.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, I see what you're saying about the cane sugar flavor.
It's apparent.
It's kind of like a cidery, slightly bready kind of note that's in there.
The roastiness I get from avocado blossom is not as apparent.
It's there.
It's there, but it's not as strong as I'm used to tasting. It definitely has this very, I want almost like, to me, the dark, not the wheat-y tasty of buckwheat, but the dark, a molasses-y-esque. I get a note of that within
this. It's like a bitter or tarry kind of note. Just gently.
Mm-hmm.
Just enough to like kind of let you know it's there.
Hmm.
There's a sweetness.
Yeah.
Which I'm not used to here. I'm used to everything I'm tasting being dry.
It's
but
true.
There is some sweetness there it's lifting those floral flavors up. So you do taste the honey.
Mm-hmm.
And kind of weirdly, I like the kind of cidery flavor of the sugar pairing against that traditional mead.
I think this
flavor.
One, the heat of it does pull things, like if I was giving it a rating, pulls the rating back a little bit. Just because it is hot, it does have a little bit of a... not a bite here for me, but like a little bit of a bite.
Yeah.
Throat burn is like, to me, like whiskey. Like it doesn't have that, but it has a little bit of that bite. I kind of like this. I think it's pretty good.
You know, you say whiskey, it does have a little bit of like a dry Manhattan kind of flavor. Like a Manhattan with just like not enough grenadine.
Yeah.
Like it's... There's some whiskey kind of notes there, and I think
interesting.
I think you're right. I think the alcohol content really helps give that perception.
I will say this is 2 months. I don't know how fast, comparative to maybe a wine yeast, that it will mellow. I'm not gonna do a side by side of that, but I do wonder comparatively how sake yeast mellows comparative. This does feel to me, aside from the slight burn, smoother. As far as like mouthfeel than a lot of other meads I have made sometimes at this point, depending.
Yeah, did you do anything to the tannin profile?
Mm-mm.
Yeah, it clings around really, really well. I'm noticing even though it's high alcohol, there's not a lot of legs.
Mm-mm.
Like you don't see any stickiness on the inside of the glass,
yeah,
which is kind of interesting. But it does hang around, and it hangs around for me on like the front of my tongue.
Yeah.
Rather than like the back or the sides of the mouth. I don't dislike this. Mm-hmm. I think that you're definitely getting, you're getting a clean ferment here.
Mm-hmm.
Like I can taste, it's so interesting. If you hadn't told me that there was a sugar wash here, I would still be like, oh, there's like a cidery note in there.
Yeah.
maybe not able to identify what that is, but mm-hmm. I can taste that that's there. I can taste that the honey's there. And I can definitely taste the heat on it. So like everything is popping.
Yeah.
And there's nothing dampening any of the flavors, and there's not a yeast contribution where I'm like, oh, that tastes like Kvass. You know, right. I'm tasting some citrus in here. It's very clean. So if that's what this yeast is intended for, it accomplished.
I really do think this would be interesting to play around with more. I do wonder how good it would be at lower ABVs. I don't necessarily know that at low ABVs this thing would crush it in my world. Something to try. Mm-hmm. But at this point, being a 14%er and this yeast intending to go to 21%, being a clean fermenter, fast fermenter, adding its own character profiles.
Yeah.
I think it succeeded really well in my book. Is it a 10 out of 10, knock it out of the park? Not quite. I do think with some more time that this thing, you know, it for me, it's 7.5 state could push it up to an 8 or a 9. A 10 out of 10 is like, I need this on tap or I'm going to die.
Yeah.
I don't know that I need this on tap or I'm
going to
die.
No, it's hard to judge at this age because there's still some of that heat, like some of those fusels still need to break down. But like, I would be really curious to see how this tastes a year from now.
Yeah.
After it's just kind of sat and did its thing. Because if the prominent flavors that are jumping out here are all that's left after the fermentation funk and the heat mm-hmm. and all that die down, this is going to be really nice.
Yeah.
And I think it requires no back sweetening because there's enough sweetness there that...
That's one thing I did like about this. 10-10, it's arguably sweet.
Mm-hmm.
But I've had things at 10-20 that I've not tasted as sweet as this.
Yeah.
So I think there's a large amount of perceived sweetness mm-hmm. retained from this yeast that I've not gotten previously.
Yeah,
so
there's definitely a sweetness. Like I would guess it's higher than
1.01.
So
I would say I'll link to the yeast below, of course. Go and buy it and try it yourself. Maybe this recipe, maybe your own. But getting this experience of tasting this yeast and trying this yeast on your own is way more valuable, honestly, than this video. Not to say anything. I think the BC and I are giving notes and things to help you out, but you trying it and experiencing it for yourself is what is really going to help you experience it truly.
Yeah.
I
would do it by this recipe. I think you've accomplished something really interesting here that I think highlights mm-hmm. what the purported benefits of this yeast were. And so I think this recipe was a great one to do this experiment with.
Wow.
I like this.
I appreciate that. I got plenty.
Yeah, fair. I'll hit you up in a year.
BC, thanks for coming and helping me decide this. My grand point is that I think you should try it. I do think it's a win in my book.
Yeah.
I think BC, he's obviously enjoys it enough to keep drinking it. So.
Stop draining the glass at this point. This is very good. It's got a lot of promise.
Go try it. Go check out BC's channel. I'll put a link down in the description below. It's doing the most. If you don't know him, you've probably seen him on the channel at this point. We're pretty close. We do a couple things together. So I hope you will check out some of his stuff. Check out content on the channel, of course. And join me for some more videos. And cheers.